నమస్కారం, వెల్కమ్ టు మై షో 1 to 1. ప్రతి నీటి పొట్టు బంగారపు పొట్టుతో సమానం. నీరు లేకుండా అభివృద్ధి లేదు, నీరు లేకుండా నాగరికత లేదు. ఎక్కడ నీరు ప్రవహిస్తుందో అక్కడ నాగరికత ఉంటుంది. ఈ నీరు ఇంకిపోయిన చోట నీటిని సృష్టించటం అనేది ఒక మహత్తర కార్యమైతే, ఆ మహత్తర కార్యాన్ని చేపట్టినటువంటి మహోన్నతుడు రాజేందర్ సింగ్ ప్రపంచంలోనే అతి ప్రతిష్టాత్మకమైనటువంటి అవార్డులను పొందినారు. స్టాక్ హోమ్ వాటర్ అవార్డు, దాదాపు నోబెల్ ప్రైజ్తో సమానమైనటువంటి అవార్డును స్వీకరించారు. అదేవిధంగా థార్ ఎడారికి సమీపంలో ఉన్నటువంటి నీరెండిన ప్రాంతాలలో నదులను ప్రవహింపజేసినటువంటి వ్యక్తి అలాంటి రాజేందర్ సింగ్. ఈ రోజున భారతదేశంలో నీటి వనరులు ఎలా వృధా అయిపోతున్నాయి, అదేవిధంగా 2 తెలుగు రాష్ట్రాలలోనూ నీటి వనరులను ఏ మేరకు సంరక్షించుకుంటున్నారు, తెలంగాణలో కాకతీయ మిషన్ పేరు మీద మనం చేస్తున్నటువంటి సాహసం ఎంతవరకు సరైనది అనే అంశం మీద మాట్లాడడానికి 1 to 1 వచ్చారు. నమస్కారం రాజేందర్.
నమస్తే.
ఓకే, సో వీ హ్యావ్ కమ్ టు నో దట్ యు హ్యావ్ బీన్ అవార్డెడ్ మెనీ ప్రెస్టైజియస్ అవార్డ్స్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ అండ్ మోస్ట్లీ యూ హ్యావ్ బీన్ కాల్డ్ ఎ వాటర్ మ్యాన్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా. సో ఐఎమ్ జస్ట్ ఇన్ ఫ్రంట్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ మ్యాన్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా, ఐ మస్ట్ బి వెరీ కేర్ఫుల్ నాట్ టు బి ఇనండేటెడ్. Right then. So here, the basic thing is conservation of water. Your major concern is, okay, across the country, almost though the country is full of rivers and at one place we have abundant water floods and at one another place, so there is no water at all. People dry because of thirst and other things. So can you strike a balance between the water abundant and areas and so there is no areas where there is no water, can you make a strike a balance and how can you do this across the country?
You know, in my country India, when we get independence,
yes,
that time our aquifer is full with water.
Okay,
our stomach is real empty because we don't have enough grains.
Right,
but my earth is full with water.
Right,
and every river,
okay,
is we can go and take bath and we can drink.
Right,
but after the independence, you can see in this country the increasing one hand drought,
okay,
and other hand flood.
Right,
so the flood and drought is the two side of the same coin.
Okay, right.
If we can catch the rains where the rain coming and we can put that water in an underground aquifer,
okay,
and subsurface aquifer,
right,
so we control the evaporation loss.
Right,
if we can control the evaporation loss and that water we can fix in the subsurface aquifer and subsurface reservoir,
okay,
so you are not losing water.
Right,
but after independence in India, what type of the water management we are taking?
Right,
just the direct flood irrigation system,
okay,
and centralized canal flood irrigation system where the no good water, but yes, they take some water from the canal,
okay,
sometime. So they are growing sugarcane, they forget the temperature, they forget the evaporation loss, they forget the relation with soil,
okay,
but they put the commercial crops there.
Right,
and so the industry come, okay, water intensive industry come and polluting industry come, so this is a really you know what we are saying today, the development, this development create a disaster today,
okay,
the disaster of flood and disaster of drought.
Right. Do you attribute something to the green revolution, because in the name of the green revolution and water was used like anything, and so big dams were constructed by the time, and so did they help in creating water or consuming water?
They are the consuming water.
Right.
You know, after independence, the crores and crores rupee expend for the dams and water bodies. And the interesting fact is, after independence, the 40% big dam only in Maharashtra.
Right.
And the highest suicide due to the scarcity of water in Maharashtra, Vidarbha.
Okay.
So you can't say the water is and the dam and water bodies, only the water bodies.
So the dams cannot address famine.
Yes.
Right, okay.
So we need community-driven decentralized water management in this country.
Okay.
If we, now we are sitting in Telangana.
So there, we have to make a shift from centralized administration of water to decentralization.
Exactly.
So okay, needs of water has to be determined by the people in local areas.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, you know, now we are sitting in Telangana.
Fine. Then.
So the Telangana have the more than thousands year old water bodies.
Okay.
The Kakatiya period create the more than thousands and thousands tank for the irrigation and the, for the drinking water, drinking for the human and drinking for cattle.
Fine.
So the that time this whole region with full water.
Almost half a lakh tanks were in existence.
Yes,
right,
yes.
Okay.
So now the old tanks is silt.
Right.
And the water capacities they not have in these things. So now I think I can thanks to your new government.
Right.
Now they make a Kakatiya mission of Kakatiya
right.
Tanks and they are rejuvenating the tanks.
The old tanks, yeah, okay.
So this is really a good effort.
A laudable job, okay.
Yes.
Right.
Because
then.
This is a traditional wisdom
okay.
and traditional knowledge system in this region. If they can rejuvenate these water body,
right.
So you can resolve the problem of the drought and flood both.
Right, right. Coming back to the point you have striken, that is, so we have been wasting water right from we got independence in the name of building big dams and other things. But during the British era, did they do anything to conserve water?
In British era, yes. The first they destroy my river Ganga.
Okay.
In 1816, in the upper Gang Nehar, a perennial beautiful river called Ganga.
No,
this is the holy river.
Yes.
And they divert in upper Bhimgoda,
right.
Upper Haridwar.
Okay.
In the 90% water going on the only in the canal, the river is dry and dead.
Right.
River is just like the sewage nala.
Okay.
The Ganga.
Right.
So this in the British period, they are doing lot of effort, but they are just creating the pipeline supply system or centralized irrigation canal system.
Right, okay.
And they are giving only for the flood irrigation system.
Right, okay.
So that time is okay.
So they created precursor to this kind of flood irrigation system. In fact, they were the instrumental in the, they laid the path for consumption of water, in fact, not for conservation.
Yes, exactly, you are right. And they destroy the right of the river.
Right.
You know, before that imperial period, in India, nobody divert the flow of the river. Anyone can't think the diversion of the river.
So man didn't tinker with the direction of the water stream.
Yes.
Anywhere.
Yes.
Yes, they tried to protect whatever they were, that was given by the nature to them.
Not only protect the stream or flow.
Right.
They are really doing the cleanness of the
fine,
stream
right.
And they are doing really a nice way using of that water.
Okay.
But after that, when you create the consumption, you think just this water is a commodity, so you are somewhere, you are create a diversion of the stream in canal and some where you divert in the this river in diverting in the pipeline.
Right. Okay.
So this this sense completely changed in imperial in English period.
Right. Okay. So in fact, you have taken village as unit for giving water either to irrigation or for drinking. So because your mission started in a village. So first you thought about a village. You thought about giving education to village, you thought about giving something to village. Finally, how could you settle down that water would be the central point for the growth of a village, and particularly a place where you were semi-arid areas, you walked there, other things. How could you come to conclusion that water is the real elevator for growth of a village? How could you come to know that?
You know, the water is really a center of the growth of rural area,
right,
village or city, everywhere, okay, or the growth of the man also, woman also. When I resigned my government service in 84,
right,
so I moved to the rural area where the pupil is displaced from that area.
Okay.
No water there.
Right.
So the old young pupil displaced to the cities.
Fine.
Nobody living there. And I start medicine because I am an Ayurvedic doctor.
Okay.
So the old pupil is sick, so I start the medicine for the sick pupil.
Right.
Free medicine I am giving.
Okay, okay.
And I am also giving the education for the children because right, that time no school there. But one day one old man came and told me, oh, what you are doing, Rajendra? You are the educated, na? So you are thinking the education can do everything.
Okay.
But you don't know our problem.
Right.
Our problem is not education, not medicine.
Fine.
Our problem is water.
Right.
So what you are doing for water? You okay, are not thinking
right,
about the water.
Okay.
So my eyes is open.
Right.
When he is asking the question.
Okay.
And I start the water conservation
right,
that
right,
time.
Right. నీటి యాజమాన్యం ఎవరి చేతిలో ఉండాలి? అది ప్రజల చేతిలో ఉండాలా, ప్రభుత్వం చేతిలో ఉండాలా? ఒకవేళ నీటి యాజమాన్యం కనుక ప్రభుత్వం చేతిలో ఉన్నట్టయితే కేంద్రీకృతంగా ఉండాలా, లేకపోతే వికేంద్రీకృతంగా ఉండాలా? ఒక ఫ్లడ్ వాటర్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత నిజానికి నీటి వినిమయం పెరిగింది కానీ నీటి సృష్టి జరగలేదు. నీటి సృష్టి జరగాలి అన్నట్టయితే, నీటిని పదిలపరచుకోవాలంటే, నీటిని పొదుపు చేసుకోవాలన్నట్టయితే జలవనరుల మీద అధికారం కానీ మరొకటి కానీ స్థానికంగా ఉండాలి. స్థానిక ప్రజలు మాత్రమే చేయగలరు. స్వరాజ్యం వచ్చిన తర్వాత వరుసగా మనకి నీటిని వినియోగించడమే నేర్చుకున్నాం కానీ నీటిని కాపాడుకోవడం నేర్చుకోలేకపోయాం. కాబట్టి మనం నీటిని వరుసగా కోల్పోతూ వచ్చాం. కాబట్టి ఒక ప్రాంతం నుంచి మరొక ప్రాంతానికి వలసలు పోవడానికి కూడా ప్రధానమైన కారణం అక్కడ నీరు లేకపోవడమే. కాబట్టి నీటిని మనం ఖచ్చితంగా కాపాడుకోవాల్సినటువంటి అవసరం ఉంది. మన దేశంలో ఒకవైపు కరువు, ఒకవైపు దుర్భిక్షం, మరోవైపు వరదలు ఉండేటువంటి ప్రాంతం ఉంది. కాబట్టి వరదలు, దుర్భిక్షము రెండు వేరు వేరు కాదు, ఒకే నాణ్యనికి రెండు వైపులు వంటివి. సో కాబట్టి ఒకదానిని పరిష్కరిస్తే మరొక దాన్ని పరిష్కరించడం సాధ్యమవుతూ ఉండేటువంటి అవకాశం ఉంటుంది. మన నీటిని వరుసగా ఉపయోగించుకోవడమే మొదలుపెట్టినట్టయితే భూమిలో ఉండేటువంటి జలవనరులు తగ్గిపోయి భూమి ఎండిపోయేటువంటి పరిస్థితి వస్తుంది, నదులు ఎండిపోయేటువంటి పరిస్థితి వస్తుంది. అలాంటప్పుడు అక్కడ నదులు ఎండిపోతాయి. తర్వాత ఒక్కసారికి వచ్చినటువంటి వరదల వల్ల మొత్తం నష్టం జరుగుతుంది. రెండింటి వల్ల కూడా మొత్తం అభివృద్ధి కుంటుపడేటువంటి అవకాశం ఉండదు. కాబట్టి అభివృద్ధి సాధించాలి అన్నట్టయితే నీటి యొక్క జల నియంత్రణ చాలా కీలకంగా ఉండేటువంటి కీలకంగా ఉండాల్సినటువంటి పరిస్థితి ఉంది. సో అభివృద్ధికి, గ్రామాభివృద్ధికి విద్య, వైద్యము ఇవి ప్రధానం అనుకుంటారు. విద్య కన్నా, వైద్యం కన్నా నీరు చాలా కీలకమైనటువంటిది. రాజేంద్ర సింగ్ జీ, సో యు ఆర్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ అన్ ఓల్డ్ మ్యాన్ హూ ఐ డోంట్ నో ఐ వెదర్ హీ ఓపెన్ యువర్ ఐస్ ఆర్ హ్యాడ్ యువర్ ఐ ఓపెన్ ఐస్ ఆల్రెడీ బీన్ ఓపెన్ బై ద టైమ్ ది ఓల్డ్ మ్యాన్ కేమ్. యు మైట్ బీ ఇన్ ది ప్రాసెస్ ఆఫ్ కమింగ్ టు దట్ పాయింట్. సో వాటర్ ఈస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ యాక్చువల్లీ. సో ఆఫ్టర్ కమింగ్ టు నో దట్ వాటర్ ఈస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ యూ ఫర్ ది విలేజ్ అండ్ యాక్చువల్లీ వాట్ హౌ డిడ్ యూ స్టార్ట్? యూ ఆర్ నాట్ ఏ ప్రొఫెషనల్ ఇంజనీర్, యూ నాట్ ఎనీ, యూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఇరిగేషన్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్ అండ్ అదర్ థింగ్స్, బట్ హౌ కుడ్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ దిస్ వాటర్ బాడీస్ అండ్ అదర్ థింగ్స్?
దట్ ఓల్డ్ మ్యాన్ క్రియేట్ ఎ కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ ఇన్ మై బ్రెయిన్ అండ్ మై హార్ట్.
రైట్.
ఎస్, ఇఫ్ వీ కెన్ కన్జర్వ్ ద రెయిన్స్
రైట్
అండ్ పుట్టింగ్ ద అండర్ గ్రౌండ్ ఎక్విఫర్, so recharge the aquifer and create the moisture in the soil, so we can create a greenery here.
Okay.
So okay, this type of the confidence when coming in my brain and my heart.
Right.
So I start the work, physical work.
Okay.
Voluntarily work.
Okay.
In Gopalpura village in Chantrewali Johri.
Right.
So the more than 12 hour to 14 hour I am working.
You worked for, okay.
In that time I am
physical,
in
physical lab.
I am
right.
In math and physical
imagine.
Work. I and we dig the base and putting the pal and give the little compaction.
Okay.
And I take a 4 year in Gopalpura village.
Okay.
And after the 4 years, this village full with water. And the old well recharge.
Okay.
And when the well is recharged, so the old young people come back to the village.
Okay.
And they are doing agriculture.
Right.
And when the first crop come, so the old young people decide, yes, now the after long year time, the grains is coming.
Okay.
So we can make a goat. Goat means daawat. Daawat
okay,
means,
so right, you can have, you can host yes, a feast, feast then.
Feast, yes, yes.
Okay, right.
So they invite the all relatives
okay.
in the village and they're sitting and they say, yes, the Gopalpur had done a great work. Finally, after the long discussion and long story, I'm giving the shortcut story to you. Finally, the decision is what type of the work done in Gopalpura we are doing in our own village.
You replicated it almost.
Yes, yes.
Right, okay.
So the villagers replicating this work.
Right.
And the same model of the Gopalpura replicating and scaling up and different type of the design and different type of the structure they are creating. So this work get boost.
Yeah.
And start in a big way. The first time I take the 4 year in a one village.
Okay. So that was
next year in the 36 villages covered.
Okay.
And multiplying.
Nice.
Today
right.
I can say the 1200 villages covered for this work.
Okay.
And more than 11,000 water bodies we create.
Right.
And the result is now the seven river subsurface aquifer full with water.
Okay.
And the old water in that area, the good crops is going on in the village called Gopalpura.
Right, okay.
Now they're growing the five crops there.
Fine, right, okay.
So this type of the change come automatically by the village people.
Right, okay.
I'm just start the water conservation work.
Also,
the rest of the work they are doing their own.
And having listened to you or the entire the story, so what I have come to know is that what you invested is not the skill of an engineer, but the skill of a farmer.
Yes.
Yes. Isn't it? Isn't it?
Yes.
Right, okay.
Yes.
So in order to conservate water, you don't require a lot of technical aspects or technical things, but only the conventional wisdom of farmer is enough to conserve water. That you have prevented.
Exactly.
Right, okay.
Exactly.
Right.
The if you create the conviction in the pupil and they start the work, they really doing in a very well meaning.
Right, okay.
And they change the face of earth.
Right, okay.
And they change the face of the human.
Right. And you touched another point as well. As far as most of the people who lauded you, who recognized you, is the ownership on water. So particularly you worked on that. So who should own water resources? The people around the water resource, or the government, or the central government, or something else. So who should own water? And particularly they tried to, the villagers came and tried to manage their own water resources. So finally you have touched upon the management of water issue also.
First you listen the case
okay.
in my area.
Right.
When after 12 years my river called Arvari is flowing.
Right.
So the government of Rajasthan reached there and they give the contact for fishing.
For fishing, right.
Yes. Oh. So people say when this river is dry, dead, no water, no fish,
okay.
So where you are going?
Okay.
They are asking from the government.
Okay.
The government say, yes, we have a act, Fishery Act 54.
Right.
So as per the act, where the water, where the fish, we are the owner of that.
Okay.
And we can give the contact
right.
to anybody. We
okay.
can give the lease to anybody.
Okay.
So the pupil is very angry.
Okay.
This work is a real natural work.
Okay.
This work is a for a nature.
Right.
Not a for a state.
Right.
Not for a company.
Right.
This work is for nature.
Right.
We conserve and protect this water
right.
and nature give the fish
okay.
and nature give the water
right.
and nature give the flow of that river.
Yes, that.
So we are the owner of this river.
Fantastic then. Okay.
And they fight
okay.
against the government.
Right.
And finally they win the all case.
Okay.
And now that river, that water only related with the pupil.
Okay.
So I can say one thing. Now,
how could the government give away the contract to a river where there is no water? It's like fishing in troubled waters or fishing no waters. That, okay. So that's fun then.
You know, this is real fun. Okay. If the people doing some work for the water,
okay,
and the government reach there and say, oh yes, we are the owner, you are not related with this,
right,
you
right.
are not, you're not ownership on that water, so nobody can do.
Finally, okay, when there is decentralization of water resources management, decentralization of management, so sure, this is the real decentralization, in fact.
Yes.
So let the villagers, let the people around water bodies have the right over that.
Yes.
So if that is the case, then, and if you just stick to that in that way, now MNCs, multinational companies have started coming this country, and the very big projects are being built, and large catchment areas and large holdings. They are trying to irrigate larger holdings. So is the government or is the market taking the agriculture in that way, irrigation in that way? So how long can we protect the rights of the villagers over these water resources with the invention, with the advent of or with the intrusion of these MNCs?
I tell you
right
real story in my area.
Fine then.
When river is flowing and water comes,
right,
so the lot of MNCs coming there,
okay,
and they is thinking the water business there,
okay,
the lot of companies coming and they are taking leash. So my pupil is very conscious. They are saying, yes, this water is not for company, this water for us, for our nature, for okay. our river. The river have the right on that water. But the MNC is never thinking about this way. So MNC is taking the lease.
Right.
Finally, my pupil is gathered and convinced to the government, and the government make a rule where the water is scarcity area, and there we can't give it any license for the MNCs,
okay,
for water. No water intensive industry is putting there, no polluting water industry putting there. So they make a rule. After 5 years change the government, and again the new government come,
right,
and they are giving the license to companies.
Okay.
So finally we go to the court.
Court of law.
Court, because that the law is already there,
right, okay,
and court give the decision in the favor of us,
right, okay, fine then.
The 43 companies, MNCs, coming there,
right,
and the all can lease the cancel.
They have gone back.
Gone back.
Right, fine.
So today I can happy with you.
Okay.
No company in my area.
Right. Okay. Who
the water extractive and
as
water
long as the people remain united, none can invade their water kingdom. Okay, thank you. So ఇది యాక్చువల్గా రాజేందర్ సింగ్ తనకి జీవిత యాత్రని మొదలుపెట్టినప్పుడు ఒక నీటి యాత్ర మొదలైన విధానాన్ని చెప్పారు. ప్రధానంగా ఒక పెద్ద ఆయన వచ్చి చెప్పిన తర్వాత ఇది ఆయనలో మార్పు మొదలైన తర్వాత తన సొంత గ్రామంలోనే ఈ కార్యక్రమాన్ని మొదలుపెట్టారు. సొంత గ్రామంలోనే వరుసగా 4 ఏళ్ల పాటు తనే స్వయంగా శారీరక శ్రమ, దాదాపు రోజుకు 12 గంటలు శారీరక శ్రమ చేసి ఒక అంతరించిపోయినటువంటి, అడుగంటిపోయినటువంటి బావిని మళ్ళీ తిరిగి తవ్వి అందులో నీటిని, జలకళను సృష్టించిన తర్వాత ఆ నీటి ద్వారా మెల్లగా వ్యవసాయం, మా చుట్టుపక్కల ఉండేటువంటి వాడు వ్యవసాయం చేసుకోవడం మొదలుపెట్టారు. వలసపోతున్నటువంటి యువకులు, యువ వ్యవసాయదారులు వెనక్కి వచ్చి సాగు చేశారు. సాగు చేసిన తర్వాత పంట పండింది. తొలి పంట వచ్చినప్పుడు అక్కడ దావత్ మొత్తం విందు చేసుకోగలిగారు. ఆ ఈ వార్త ఆ నోట మొత్తం ఇతర గ్రామాలకి ప్రారంభ వెళ్ళింది. అలాగే రాజేందర్ సింగ్ తన సొంత గ్రామంలో కూడా వెళ్ళి ఇదే కార్యక్రమాన్ని చేపట్టారు. రాజేందర్ సింగ్ జీ, సో యూ రిజనవేటెడ్ గివింగ్ ఇన్స్టిల్లింగ్ న్యూ లైఫ్, న్యూ వాటర్ టు ది 7 dead rivers, ఆల్మోస్ట్ 7 dried rivers. సో రీజనవేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ రివర్, బట్ ఇట్స్ వీ ఆల్వేస్ హియర్ అబౌట్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ లైక్ మాంగ్స్ అండ్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ who originated rivers like Gautam Maharshi or something else. So okay, is it humanly possible, a man reviving a water flow? Is it possible? How could you and your people make 7 rivers alive?
River rejuvenation not a miracle.
Right, okay.
River rejuvenation is simple science. And I can say a very common sense science.
Common
not
sense.
Not a calculative science.
Okay, right then.
You know, when the rains is coming,
okay,
we catch the water,
right,
and putting the underground aquifer,
right.
So we control the evaporation loss,
okay.
And when the subsurface aquifer recharges, so the flow is coming out,
okay,
and river is flowing,
right. Okay.
Yes, you know, you can change the history in some hour,
like infusing blood into human body.
Yes.
Right. Okay.
But you can't change the geography
right.
in a some year.
Okay.
Minimum take a 12 year.
Oh, right.
So continuously we recharge the aquifers.
Okay.
And cumulative water level come up.
Right.
And flowing the river.
That's okay. With the cumulative effect of on aquifer.
Yes.
Yes. Right. Okay.
Yes. And river is flowing.
Right.
So first the Arvari River flowing in 96, and after that our Sarsa River, Bhagani River, Jahajwali River, Ruparel River,
okay,
and Sabi or Maheshwara River.
Right.
So these seven river is now flowing on subsurface or surface, both level.
So now they can be considered as perennial rivers?
Oh yes.
Yes, right, okay.
You can say
right.
the where the cumulative recharge
okay.
and flowing the stream. So you can say the perennial river.
Right, okay.
The, if the water is full here.
Right.
So you can say the perennial river.
Right, okay.
So meri nadiyan shuddh sada neera hokar behti hain.
Okay, right. So here you might have come to know about one river in Hyderabad. It is the name of the river is Musi River. So it was once, as you said, it was once a perennial river, and it was once very flooded also. People were inundated, many places were inundated here. Such was the flow of the river. But today, you don't find such river. So there is a river, but the river is not doing the job of a river. So can we regenerate such rivers?
Yes.
Right.
You know, now your Musi River is not a river.
Right.
It is now a
sewage
nala. But first you understand when this start this process.
Right.
The first time in 1932, a commissioner of Banaras, the name is Hawkins.
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 Hawkins, okay. Right. Okay.
So this commissioner make a GR, government report.
Okay.
For the beautification of the Banaras city.
Okay.
We can link three dirty drains direct with Ganga.
Okay.
So the people of Banaras, they are opposing.
Right.
And they are saying, what you are doing, Mr. Hawkins?
Hmm.
The Ganga is our mother. You
yeah.
can't do this
right.
dirty drain in our stomach of our mother.
Right.
So he say, yes, I can't do, but you decide. My government give the 20 lakh rupees for the beautification of your city.
Right.
So if you want the beautification of your city and you want this money, so the only way first we can turn this dirty river in the Ganga.
Yes.
So the, you know, the Indian people.
Okay.
The Banaras people say, oh yes, okay.
Right.
You do something, beautification.
Right.
So, ye jo lalach hai na vikas ka.
Right.
This is the dirty lalach.
Yes.
This lalach come from our brain and our heart. So, this Musi River is not dirty of our urine or our shit.
Right.
This is the dirty of our brain and our heart.
Excellent, excellent. Right. Okay. Fine.
So
the way we think has spoiled over us.
Yes.
Right. Okay.
So, in 1932, that order start from Banaras. After that, the everywhere in my country, in India, the all dirty source, they are linked with the river.
Right. Okay.
Before that, no. Before that, only the way of the treating of the dirty stream, the Tirkundiya Vavastha.
Okay.
The first tank, take a dirty water. Second tank, with the better water.
Right.
And third, that third structure on the fractured aquifer.
Okay.
And that water is going in subsurface, and the way of river osmosis, the purified the water, and that water going in the river.
So the three tanks, in fact, okay. Trikundi. Right, okay.
So that is the way of the purification.
Of sewage water.
Yes.
Right. But giving away, but leaving that system, they are just linking the dirty water, drainage water to the main rivers.
Exactly.
Okay.
So this is the weakness of our brain.
Right.
And our culture and our attitude.
Fine.
With water.
Pollution of thinking finally made the water polluted.
Yes.
Right, okay.
Polluted thinking make a water polluted.
Right, okay. So that was what has happened. Same thing must have happened to Musi also.
Yes.
So that's what you are trying to attribute.
Yes.
Right, okay.
So when that start in this work in Banaras.
Right.
So the same time you can think about the Musi River.
Right, okay.
Before that, this river is not dirty.
Right.
You can explore the in your archive.
Yes.
Before that, river is perennial and pure flow in this river.
Right.
And within the 90 years,
okay,
or round about 100 years, this river is created dirty river.
Right.
So now, if we want this river again rejuvenate, so the three simple things we can do.
Right. What are those three?
First, we make a principle. River and sewer separation.
Right.
Dirty river stream coming in the river.
Right. No.
So river and sewer separation.
Yeah.
Is a real principle you adopt in
that
Hyderabad.
Is step one.
Step one.
Right.
Second, in Hyderabad, you know, some old water bodies and water structures in Banjara Hill and other portion.
Right.
So, if there the water harvesting or conservation.
Right, okay.
So, that water going in the streams and fractures of the hills.
Okay.
And that flow come in the Musi River.
Right.
So, that Musi River is purified the full year with the pure water.
Right, okay.
With pure water.
Right.
So, again, now is, yes, your all catchment of the Hyderabad,
right,
is the cement concrete jungle.
Right.
So this is now is real difficult.
Right. Okay.
But we can make some new source.
Okay.
For the rejuvenation and for the flow of the Musi River.
That's step two.
Yes. And, step two.
And
the third step.
Right.
Is we can make discipline.
Right.
With the people and with the state government.
Okay.
They create a greenery in the both side.
Right.
Of the stream.
Okay.
And that greenery can make a slow recharge.
Okay.
Of the aquifer.
Right.
And they make a maintain of the flow.
That's the third step.
Yes, that is the third step.
Right.
So if we can take initial level of the three step,
okay,
we can see the visual impact in Musi River.
Right, we can see fresh water in Musi Nadi.
Yes.
Right then.
Yes.
Right. So రాజేందర్ సింగ్ మొత్తానికి అనేక విషయాల్ని ప్రస్తావిస్తూ ముందుగా నదులకు సంబంధానికి వచ్చినప్పుడు నదులను దాదాపు 7 ఎండిపోయినటువంటి నదులను లో జలకళ తెప్పించినటువంటి విధానం మనం చూసాం. సాధారణంగా ఒక నదిని ఇచ్చినటువంటి వాళ్ళని మహర్షి అని ముని అని చెప్పడం అనుకుంటుంది. ఒక్కొక్క నదికి ఒక్కొక్క మహర్షి పేరు చెప్పినటువంటి అంశం ఉంటుంది. నదిని ఇవ్వడమే చాలా గొప్ప అనుకునేటువంటి భావన. నిజానికి నదిని మహర్షులు మునిలు ప్రకృతి సిద్ధంగా వస్తుంది. నదిని సంరక్షించడానికి పెద్ద జ్ఞానం కూడా అక్కర్లేదు, పెద్ద విశేషమైన పరిజ్ఞానం కూడా అక్కర్లేదు. జస్ట్ కామన్ సెన్స్ అనేది మాకు కామన్ సెన్స్తో వ్యవహరిస్తే నదిని కాపాడుకోవచ్చు అనేటువంటి భావన కలుగుతుంది. సో వర్షపు నీరు కింద పడిన తర్వాత కింద పడినటువంటి నీరుని మనం మెల్లమెల్లగా మనం ప్రిజర్వ్ చేస్తూ వస్తున్నప్పుడు దాంట్లో ఉండేటువంటి కింద ఉండేటువంటి ఆక్విఫైర్ డెఫినెట్గా జల సంపద అనేది పెరిగిన తర్వాత మెల్లమెల్లగా కొంచెం వాటర్ లెవెల్స్ పెరగడంతో ఒక దాదాపు కొన్ని సంవత్సరాలకి మళ్ళీ తిరిగి ఆ ఎండిపోయిన నదుల్లో మనం నీళ్లను చూడడం సాధ్యమవుతుంది. రజేందర్ సింగ్ జీ, so in fact we are making rivers dead with the, as you said, the pollution of our thinking, and we are making the rivers polluted with our pollution. So in fact if you create awareness among people and we can save water, all these things. So, but finally, having read about your biography and other things, you had a tough time with some mining people and other things. Usually, whenever you want to do certain things, usually this you come on the way of some other people who want to occupy water, who want to misuse water, who want to encroach these lakes and other things. In fact, the state government of Telangana is very tough on those who are encroaching the lakes. But most of the lakes have already been encroached and disappeared also. But some of the lakes, they are trying to protect it. So you have had your tough time with these forces. So how could you handle such forces?
You know, today, the real problem for water,
yeah,
one hand, encroachment of the water resource,
right,
and water bodies and water land. In Musi River have the three type of the land.
Okay.
One land is,
right,
blue land.
Blue land.
Blue land.
Right.
The blue land means where the flow the water.
Right, okay. Pure.
Yeah. And the green land.
Right.
Green land means where the water come in the flood.
Right.
And the red land,
right,
where the water come in the high flood land, in the 100-year, the highest flood point of the this river.
Right, okay.
But you know, now your government is not putting on the record, okay, not putting on the map,
okay,
not putting in the notification.
Right.
So first I suggest to your government.
Yes, right.
The all water body, like river, lakes, tanks, ponds, everything. First, identification
of
the land.
Right, okay.
And the demarcation
of, right, whether of the land. Whether it belongs to blue, red or green.
Yes.
Right.
And notification with map.
Yes.
They all records maintain.
Right.
Without these records, your encroachment going on the high level.
Right. Okay.
Because now is only the common property with you, just water bodies.
Right.
Lakes, ponds, tanks, rivers.
Fine.
So first thing initiated by the government, identification, demarcation and notification with map.
Right.
The second thing, we need a river rejuvenation policy.
Right.
Where we can ensure the water right of the river and water right of the tank and water right of the nature and water right of the human.
Right.
So we can ensure the equal right for life.
Right.
For survival.
Right.
For livelihood. And the third thing, this is also duty of the government.
Right.
They make a real act for the equal right to life in the light of Indian Constitution.
Right.
Because the Indian Constitution ensuring your life, the right of life. So these three action for the government.
You mean to say equal right of people over resources? Equal right among people?
Yes.
Right,
on water.
Right.
On water.
Right.
Because
so the rich man should not have more right and the poor man is deprived of having right, not like that.
For
so,
water.
Right.
For water.
Yes.
I am not saying on property.
Right.
I am not saying on the land.
At least on water.
I am saying on water.
Right. Right.
This right giving by the nature.
Right.
And by the giving the by the constitution.
Right.
So why we are not following the Indian constitution,
right,
in the light of the water?
Yes. It's property of the people as a whole.
Yes.
Right. Okay.
And the second thing, the duty of the pupil. Now, you know, after the increasing the rate of the real estate.
Right.
The pupil is just blind.
Right.
And encroaching everywhere.
Yes, that's the biggest problem.
This is the biggest problem.
Yes.
So, I know the pupil is not easy. But if we have real act and they can give the hard punishment for this type of the work.
Right.
So we can control that.
Okay.
So the pupil
and the law should be in such a way so it can stall further encroachments.
Yes.
That one way. And regaining the lost land from the encroachers.
Yes.
So for that also you need to have exercise.
Yes.
Right. Okay.
Yes.
Right.
And the, you know, the river or water is not only belonging with the state or with the government.
Right.
The water belonging with the state or with the pupil.
Okay.
The both is equal right, they have the equal right on
right.
water.
Okay, okay.
So if we have the equal right, so we have the equal responsibility.
Fine.
Without responsibility, you can't enjoy your right.
Fine then.
So first, the pupil understand the responsibility.
Right.
About the water.
Okay. Right. So you have talked about rivers and other water bodies, particularly, and you had your own contribution. That's called Johad.
Yeah, you know,
okay.
What is the relation with the river and Johad?
Yeah.
If the water comes in the Johad,
okay,
and discharging the aquifer,
right,
finally that water coming in the river.
Yes, final, right. So that's Johad is a key point to regenerate river.
Yes.
Yes. That's what it's a battery, it's a charger.
Yes, it is a real source of
right.
the river.
Okay.
Without Johar,
right,
you can't maintain the flow in the river.
Right.
You know,
okay,
in India,
right,
and like you can say the Telangana,
right,
no glacier,
okay,
no river comes from the glacier.
Glaciers.
The all water comes from the subsurface aquifer,
right,
and the flow of the subsurface
right.
aquifer.
Okay.
The old river of the Telangana,
yes,
is the only source is the subsurface aquifer recharge.
Right.
So
okay,
if we are not creating recharge,
right,
so the water can't come in the river.
So that's okay. That's finalized, right?
So we need,
right,
we recharge the aquifers in
right.
Telangana,
right,
or in this country,
right,
if we want the river flow.
Right. Okay. This country is blessed with, endowed with wonderful and natural lakes. So most of the country is known for its lakes too. So here there are many lakes here in other part of the state. There is Kolleru Lake, and in here we created a very big pond like Hussain Sagar. It's also in a sorry state right now, and the water is thoroughly polluted. So in order to save these kind of natural lakes and very big ponds, and what measures do you suggest? And in fact, suppose if I ask you some suggestion or some method to save even Hussain Sagar lake also, what do you suggest then?
You know, the Hussain Sagar,
yeah,
near the Hussain Sagar, this Hyderabad Municipal Corporation make a dump.
Yes.
If you are making near the dump of near the water.
Right.
So the all the fill there, so that recharging flow coming in the lake.
And it's a place of immersion of Ganesh idols also.
Yes.
Right, okay.
Yes, so I can say near water body, we not allow any type of the dirty thing.
Yes, okay.
That dirtiness going finally with water in the lake.
Right, okay.
So we stop the dirtiness
right.
of the city.
Okay.
Near the lake.
Right.
Hussain Sagar is a beautiful lake,
right,
and clean water,
right,
but you know the urbanization increasing
right,
of the
right.
Hyderabad and the increasing the pollution that lake.
Right, okay.
So we control the pollution in the lakes, the pollution can't coming in the lake.
Right, okay. So you talked about, mostly you talk about social engineering in fact.
Yes.
Rather than engineering. So how do you define social engineering, and let's try to conclude, and how social engineering will help us in preservation of water and making our country wealthy and people wealthy.
You know, in the world,
right,
a discipline called civil engineering.
Right.
So what is the meaning of the civil engineering?
Right.
The meaning of the civil engineering is the social engineering of water.
Right.
The civil engineering giving the solution of the water,
right,
the cleanness,
okay,
and flow, they ensure the flow, and that engineering ensuring the environment and ecology, everything,
right,
with the water.
Okay.
But now the name of the civil engineering, our modern engineer, they forget,
right,
the real
meaning,
meaning of the civil
the spirit
engineering.
Spirit and soul of civil engineering.
Yes.
Civil and civic people, right, okay.
They forget.
Right, okay.
So, if I am speaking the social solution.
Right.
So, I am speaking the social engineering about the water.
Right, okay.
And this is a, this engineering coming with the common sense of our civil society.
Right.
So, we give the respect to the our civil society.
Right.
And that civil society take the responsibility about the cleanness of the water.
Fantastic.
Source. Like Hussain Sagar.
Right.
You know, when the Hussain Sagar make it dirty.
Right.
Because my municipal corporation and my state government is not bothered with the civil society.
Right.
They all right giving to the engineers.
Right.
And engineers enjoy the,
okay,
the money. They are not enjoying the cleanness of
so
water.
Giving the right back to the people is real social engineering and civil engineering.
Yes.
So thank you very much, Rajendra Singh ji.
Thank you.
So
thank
you. The Inati one-to-one show. అంతిమంగా సోషల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ ద్వారా నీటి మీద అందరికీ ప్రజలకి హక్కుని కాపాడడం సాధ్యమవుతుంది అంటున్నారు రాజేందర్ సింగ్. ఇది ఈనాటి వన్ టు వన్. మరో టాపిక్తో మళ్ళీ కలుద్దాం. బాయ్.